Hello everyone, myself Sri Shakti. We are from Arunai Engineering College, final year CS department. I am very glad to represent to our project in front of you. Our project topic IoT based smart farming. My team members are Syed Mufeed Ahmad, Jyothi Swaran, Vijay Kumar. Our project mentor, Dr. M. Jyothi Kumar, Department of CSE.
Okay, now let's get into the slides. First topic is abstract.
The time that farmer needed to introduce the smart farming system for higher crop yield. The productivity with the compilation of data from sensor and modern electronic gadget. The farmer can monitor agriculture field. The smart farming can forecast weather data, switching on the pump motor, acknowledging the depthness of soil terms of moisture level with the help of sensor, which are interface process model Arduino Uno. The smart farming system can be operated from anywhere with the help of networking technologies. On joining process on research and development in smart agriculture and artificial intelligence can be cutting edge technology in data computing and resource optimization. The identification of the technique of smart farming that can give the boost up to the deteriorating traditional agriculture sector. Use of smart technique like precision farming, efficient water management, soil moisture and humidity monitoring are source should method to increase yield per air land. Precision agriculture avoid the improper and excess applications of pesticides and fertilizer and enable the farmer to use land according to its quality and nature.
Hi, it's Jyothi Swaran from CSE final year, Arunai Engineering College. I am going to talk about existing system and proposing system. Existing system in the sense what we are traditionally following in the field of agriculturing. Proposing system in the sense what we are proposing the new methodology in the field of agriculturing system. Existing agricultural practices. In existing farming, where we need to monitor the field in every day. We need to monitor the watering system in manually. It's really complicated to do in every day. Also, lot of water waste is possible. It's really hard to maintain the field of monitoring in water level and weather and the temperature also. Proposed system. Proposing system, we no need to monitor the field of field in physically. We can do through an IoT page. We can control the watering system both manually and automatically. Based on the moisture sensor, we can do the automatic watering system. Through an DH11, we can monitor the temperature from the current place. Through node MCU, we can know the every update instantly from the IoT web page.
Hi everyone. Myself is Sigmar, a finalist student from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering in Arunai Engineering College. I'm going to explain about the sensors like temperature and humidity sensor and soil moisture sensor. And then I'm going to explain about the brain of our project, like that means a microcontroller, Arduino Uno, and then finally Wi-Fi module like ESP8266.
Soil moisture sensor. Soil moisture sensors measure the water content in the soil and can be used to estimate the amount of stored water in the soil horizon. The sensors do not measure water in the soil directly. Instead, they measure changes in some other soil property that is related to water content in a predictable way. Each sensor manufacturer uses different technologies to measure soil moisture content. DHT11 sensor. It is a low-cost digital sensor for sensing temperature and humidity. The sensor can be easily interfaced with any microcontroller such as Arduino, Raspberry Pi, etc. to measure the humidity and temperature instantaneously. Working principle. DHT11 sensor consists of a capacitive humidity sensing element and thermistor for sensing temperature. The humidity sensing capacitor has two electrodes with a moisture holding substrate as a dielectric between them. Change in the capacitor value occurs with change in humidity levels. The IC measure processes this change resistance values and change them into digital form. Arduino Uno board. It is an open source electronics platform based on easy to use hardware and software. Arduino boards are able to read inputs, light on a sensor, a finger on a button, or a Twitter message and turn it into an output, like activating a motor, turning on an LED, publishing something online. You can tell your board what to do by sending a set of instructions to the microcontroller on the board. To do so, you use the Arduino programming language and the Arduino software based on processing. Over the years, Arduino has been the brain of thousands of projects, from everyday objects to complex scientific instruments. It is inexpensive, open source and extensive software and a cross-platform. ESP8266. It is a Wi-Fi module, is a self-contained SoC with the integrated TCP/IP protocol stack on that given any microcontroller access to your Wi-Fi network. It is capable of either hosting an application or offloading all Wi-Fi networking functions from another application processor. It is extremely cost-effective board with a huge and ever-growing community. This module has a power enough onboard processing and storage capability that allows it to be integrated with sensors and other application-specific devices through its GPIOs with a minimal development upfront and minimal loading during runtime. Its high degree of on-chip integration allows for minimal external circuitry, including the front-end module is designed to occupy minimal PCB area. It supports APSD for VoIP applications and Bluetooth coexistence interfaces. It contains a self-calibrator RF allowing it to work under all operating conditions and requires no external RF paths.
Hi, myself Syed Mufeed Ahmad. I am from Computer Science Department, Arun Engineering College, final year. And in our topic, I am going to continue the methodology. So methodology is the topic where we are going to see the working condition of our project, that is smart farming based off IoT. So methodology, here we are trying to maintain the water level and flow as it is required by relay switch on of the pump. So soil moistures that are fixed under the ground field is used to check the moisture sensor. So moisture sensor used to sense the moisture condition in the wetland. So initially the water level reading is taken and decisions are made according to it. Then the temperature sensor is fixed at the center of the field and it get overall reading of the temperature of the soil. So while reading the temperature of the soil, these sensors are connected to the Arduino where we will get the readings. So using Arduino, we are connecting these sensors and we are getting the readings. And then all the sensor will send data to Arduino and data will be forwarded to WSN. So that is a sensor network, wireless sensor network system. So then the threshold value will be set according to the crop specified. Wherever any sensor reaches a threshold value, message alert is sent to the user and action is taken according to it. So the flow chart. So this is how the flow of the project is going to be. So when the sensors are read by, when the values are read by the sensors, the temperature and humidity sensor starts going to work and then reading shows on the LCD display. So that is we are used in this system. And using soil moisture sensor, the threshold value, when the threshold value is very low, that is when the moisture sensor reaches 2, 3 or and below 10 or 40, so then the motor will be turned off. So if it is above 40, that is the wetland, the motor will not turn on automatically. So this is controlled by a microcontroller and a server is set. So through the server, we are going to get the readings in mobile phone and the output is made in the mobile phones. So this is our system and this is how we are make our connections, and this is Arduino Uno and this is a transformer and this is Node MCU and this is a relay module and this is the DH11 sensor which is used to sense the humidity and temperature, and this is the moisture sensor where it is going to work as a main component, so that is going to sense the moisture of the soil and just access the motor to generate the water. So now the soil is in a dry condition. Now I am going to keep the sensor, and when it is sensed, it's showing the moisture level as 0.01, and now the motor is turned on and the flow of water is taking place. Okay, and the flow of water is taking place. So this is the procedure when it is in dry condition. So the motor will turn on and the water will flow, and now it is wet, so it is showing that the moisture is 234 and now it is stopped, the motor is turned off automatically. So that's the main process of this project. So now I'm going to conclude our project. So with the incorporation of WSN and IoT, we can upgrade the agriculture farm. So this system enables to check the quality of the soil moisture and the growth of the crops. So by using this system, we will know the growth of the crops and we can identify the disease of the crops, and we can know the temperature of the surroundings, and with the help of soil moisture sensor, we can know how the moisture condition is there in the wetland or farmland. So with the help of the soil moisture, we can just make the pump to get flow through the full agriculture land. So farmers are able to control various equipment related to agriculture and monitor their crop on smartphone. So using smartphone, they can control their irrigation process. So when they are far away from somewhere, so then they can control there from there itself. So that is the main concept we are dealing with this. So using this system helps to increase the rice, wheat and maize and other agriculture products, so that IoT capable to control the condition of yield and growth. It can also be to able to check soil temperature, humidity, etc.
And finally, we thank our dynamic vice chairman, respected registrar and motivated and respected principal for giving this interactive technical platform. And I extend my heartfelt gratitude for Dr. Suresh A. Shan, Chairman, Computer Science Society of India, Mumbai Chapter, Mumbai, for being the best support to us in taking initiative for rural development. In this regard, we extend this initiative to CSI for the greater extent in the upcoming years. Thank you.